Hi guys, this is Sheetal. Today I will be making these aster flowers. So let's begin. These flowers are really interesting to paint and draw. So let us begin with the basics. First we'll be making the flowers. The center of the flower, it is oval in the shape, and next we will be making the outer layer of the flower in which the petals will be made. When we make the flower, the end part of these petals are really curvy in the nature. You can also draw some petals from between the petals which I have made earlier. Next, we will be making the flower view. I had already made the flower from the center point at the above, and now I will be making the flower which is viewed from the sideways. You can also try these flowers from different views, as it looks perfectly beautiful when you draw it. Next, we will be making some cute buds. This is a closed bud and this is a little bit opening one. Next, we will be making leaves. Its aster flower leaves are a little bit longer, and when it comes to the buds, it gets smaller and smaller, as these are the new little leaves. Now let's decide the colors. First I will paint the colors from my palette and then I will name it. I'm using crimson lake and some of the cobalt blue to give it a purple color of this flower. You can also try a purple color if you have in your palette, but if you don't have it, you can try a mix of crimson lake and cobalt blue, which will give a perfect purple look which is needed for this flower. First, we will color the base with a lighter purple, and then we will give a deeper consistency to make it look more beautiful. Next, yellow. This yellow will be used for the middle part of the flower and the little bit of orange to give it a shade. I will be using the sap green for the leaves and the mixture of sap green and orange to give an olive green color. Next is the yellow color for the envelope which I will be painting, and the burnt sienna. These are the colors. You can have a note of it. This is a 300 GSM sketchbook which I have made from Canson papers. First, let us make the purple shade. I need a very little thin consistency. Therefore, I am mixing these colors with lots and lots of water. Let us begin by making the center of our flower. I am not putting the color all over. I am just pointing my brush towards the paper and leaving some white gaps. I know it's not possible to see through the camera. And I'm giving an orange shade at the side part of this flower to give it a shadow. Now let us begin with painting our petals. I will be painting this flower in a scattered manner. I will not be painting these petals from a one side, because it will not give it a good look when I will paint from one side. And you can see that the orange and yellow is bleeding into the purple, which will look very beautiful once it gets dried up. Similarly, I will be painting other flowers which is there in this envelope. I will get back to you when I will paint all the flowers in this envelope. Till then, you can join me in this process. Now it's time to paint our envelope. I will be using the Nepal Yellow and the Burnt Sienna to give it a shade of an older envelope. I am painting from the sideways and not in the between. I will be just smudging the color in between by taking the color from outside into the middle. Now I am putting Burnt Sienna to give it an older look at the corners of the envelope, and I will be giving a more shade between the flower petals. I am giving a darker look at the corners and also the boundary of the envelope where it is sticked. So enjoy the process. If you are interested in doing craft work, I have another channel for you. So you can jump onto it from my description below. And if you want me to paint some different topics, you can also comment below and let me know what you want me to paint next. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Let us give our aster flower some denser look with a darker purple shade. I am using the space which I had left before to show that the petals are hiding behind the lighter purple petals. Giving them a denser look with a darker purple. leaves with a sap green and some olive. Similarly, I will be painting all the leaves in this envelope and give it a beautiful greenery look with my aster flowers. You can also try the different shades of colors for these leaves. It can be darker, lighter. I will be also mixing this olive green in these leaves to give it a shade, as you can see, because if we paint the leaf in a only single color, then our painting will really look very flattened. So try using different shades of colors in your paintings. I was thinking that something is missing in this envelope, so I will be painting a small flower on the right hand side of my envelope. I had painted this flower to give it a look that the flower has fallen from this envelope. It's time to add some splatters to our painting. I'm using this paper towel to hide the envelope so that the sprinkles does not fall on envelope and make it a shabby look. I just need the sprinkles on the side of the envelope. I'm using the purple shade, and I will be also using some gamboge yellow, as I have used this yellow in the center part of my aster flowers. I'm also using my tip of brush to paint a little bigger droplets of flower. I hope you liked my painting and the process, and I also enjoyed talking with you for the first time in this tutorial. Almost finished my painting. I'm just giving a darker look to my leaves. I'm painting a little veins to my leaves so that they look really life in the painting. Really like the process with me. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. I hope you like these aster flowers. I will bring a new tutorial very early for you. Till then, bye bye.